The Realme 2 Pro has been one of the great budget smartphones this year. And it's the phone that really put Realme as the new emerging smartphone brand in India. But now the Realme U1 has arrived, so is it another winner from Realme? Well, let's get real and take a look. Hey guys, this is Rupesh from Beebom.com and this is the brand new Realme U1. Well, I'll be talking about my first impressions of the device today, but before we start, I'd suggest you hit the bell icon to get notified every time we post an awesome new video. Now that you've done that, let's talk about the Realme U1. So this is the Realme U1 and the Realme 2 Pro side by side from the back. Now let's take a look at them from the front. Can you tell which one is the U1 and which one is the 2 Pro? You can't, right? I know, if you look closely, you will notice a subtle difference, but the point is that the Realme U1 looks almost identical to the Realme 2 Pro. And it's not just the looks, there's a lot of other similarities between the Realme U1 and the Realme 2 Pro. But there are a couple of major changes that the Realme U1 brings, so let's talk about the new things in the Realme U1. The biggest change comes in the form of the processor. The Realme U1 is the first phone in the world to come with a MediaTek Helio P70 on board. So obviously, there's a lot of questions around it. While it's too early to judge the performance, things look positive even though the U1 is only available in a 3 and 4GB RAM variant. Anyway, let's start with the benchmarks. The Helio P70 on the Realme U1 not only beats the Snapdragon 636 in benchmarks, it even outperforms the Snapdragon 660 on the Realme 2 Pro, which is honestly pretty impressive and pretty surprising. I know the Realme 2 Pro has an underclocked Snapdragon 660, but it's still pretty impressive. When it comes to the real-world performance, the Realme U1 has been doing well so far. Things have been pretty smooth, be it during usual day-to-day usage or during gaming. Games like Asphalt 9 and Tekken run fine on the phone, and even PUBG Mobile runs on medium graphics settings by default, which is definitely great for a budget smartphone. Plus, the Helio P70 is set to bring better AI capabilities, faster face recognition, and a lot more. Well, I cannot comment on the AI capabilities, but the face unlock here is one of the fastest I've ever used. Just take a look. It's super fast and it even feels a little faster than OnePlus phone, so that's saying something. So yeah, so far the MediaTek Helio P70 processor on the Realme U1 seems like a pretty capable processor for a budget smartphone. But yeah, we're still testing things out and we'll reserve a judgment for our full review. Another big change from the Realme 2 Pro comes on the camera front. The Realme U1 comes with a 13MP plus 2MP dual camera setup, so it's obvious that it won't match the cameras on the Realme 2 Pro. Anyway, here are a few shots taken from the phone, and while it's too early to judge, the Realme U1 cameras seem decent enough. Some photos do look a bit average, but this is a budget phone, so I'm not expecting a lot. Compared to the likes of the Redmi Note 6 Pro and the Realme 2 Pro, the Realme U1 cameras do seem a little underwhelming, but it's not too bad to be honest. On the video front, there's only 1080p support, which is a little surprising because the Helio P70 does support 4K video recording. So I'm not sure why Realme hasn't enabled that, but hopefully the 1080p video quality will be good enough to make up for it, which doesn't seem like the case so far. Coming to the front cameras, the Realme U1 comes with a 25MP f2.0 camera, which on paper seems pretty impressive. Well, here are a few selfies from the phone. As you can see, the selfie camera definitely seems pretty good with or without portrait mode, so that's pretty amazing. When compared to the Realme 2 Pro and the Redmi Note 6 Pro, most of the times I tend to prefer the selfies taken from the Realme U1 due to natural colors and good details. So the selfie camera on the U1 seems pretty good, so that's really nice. Overall, the Realme U1's cameras might not be the best in this price range, but they certainly seem decent. Although again, it's too early to say and we'll reserve our judgment on the cameras for a full review. Well, that was it when it comes to the new things in the Realme U1. The rest of the phone is pretty similar to the Realme 2 Pro and that's not a bad thing. There's obviously the same design and build, and that means the Realme U1 is a pretty good looking smartphone, thanks to the plastic back that looks like glass and the nice and sharp 6.3-inch IPS LCD display with the trendy teardrop notch, which I really like. The display here just looks beautiful. Apart from the same great design and the display as the Realme 2 Pro, the Realme U1 also has the same usual buttons, the fingerprint scanner on the back, which is very fast, so I like it. And there's the micro USB port, the single speaker, and the headphone jack on the bottom. The Realme U1 also has the same 3500mAh battery, and while it's not very huge, it should be decent enough. There's a 5V 2A charger in the box, which should charge the phone fairly quickly. Lastly, there's the same feature-packed ColorOS 5.2 on top of Android 8.1 Oreo. And while that should be fine for most people, I'm pretty disappointed. I mean, Android Pie has been here for quite some time now, so it's a little sad to see new phones coming with Android Oreo. Plus, I've never been a fan of ColorOS. I know it has all the features you need, but it just seems cluttered and unpolished. I just hope Realme refines it in the future. Anyway, it's pretty clear that the Realme U1 is the Realme 2 Pro with slightly inferior cameras, a different processor, and probably a lower price tag. I mean, at the time of shooting this video, we don't know the price of the Realme U1, but it's rumored to be around Rs 12,000. And at that price, the Realme U1 should be a capable budget smartphone. The Realme 2 Pro-like design is great and premium. The teardrop notch and the display should be a standout in this price range. And the performance with the new Helio P70 processor seems very promising and better than the competition. Not everything is positive though. I don't like the fact that there's still Oreo here and I've never been a fan of ColorOS. Also, I'm a little skeptical about the cameras. So yeah, if you're wondering if you should buy the Realme U1, I'll suggest you to wait for our full review, which is coming soon, so stay tuned for that. Well, those are our first impressions of the Realme U1, and if you have any questions around the device, just drop them in the comment section below and we'll make sure to answer them in our full review. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and share it with your friends. Lastly, subscribe to our channel for more amazing tech videos. Well, that's me signing off. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.